For 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun. Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win the Granite State Challenge. Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
Okay, and hi, everybody. Welcome to another game of Granite State Challenge. It's nice to have you aboard with us once again as we are into our fourth week of still a very new season, but not new in longevity, because we are celebrating our 25th anniversary this year of Granite State Challenge. We have a new set, a new look, and also some new technological advances as well. As an example, following each telecast, we will put the game show up on YouTube or on iTunes Music Store, and you can check them out down the road as you please. So also check out our website and get more information on that. All right, let's get into tonight's game and introduce you to the schools and the players. First of all, we have the team from Contucket Valley Regional High School with an enrollment of almost 1,200 students located in New Hampshire's Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm David Davis, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Alice Hale, and I'm a freshman.
Hi, I'm Emily Yang, and I'm a sophomore.
Hi, I'm Josiah Sterling, and I'm a junior.
With us for the program as well, the coaches for the team, Molly Epic and John Manley. Their alternate tonight is Ed Billmore, and they are the Cougars of Contucket Valley Regional High School. So that's the team from ConVal. Let's introduce you to their opponents tonight. It's the team from Monadnock Regional High School, with its enrollment of about 1,000 students located in New Hampshire's Cheshire County.
Hi, I'm James Toy, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Sarah Dick, and I'm a junior.
Hi, I'm Tom Nason, and I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Steve Nikopragas, and I'm a senior.
The team is coached by Bill Quintilio. His alternates tonight are Zach Giroux and Brian Murphy, the Huskies of Monadnock Regional High School. And our last introduction before we get into our first round is to let you know who the judges will be for tonight. And once again, we welcome back Mary Riley Potter and Jim McShane and thank them for their hard work each and every week. All right, we play our game in four rounds. We'll begin with a 10-point toss-up round. We know that we have a bonus round and a 60-second round just around the corner. But right now, 10-pointers for ConVal and Monadnock Regional. Here we go. American patriot Alexander Hamilton died a violent death. How did he die? Sarah of Monadnock Regional.
In a duel against...
He was shot in a duel is all we need. Absolutely right. Scientists call the top part of the wave the crest. What name do they use? David of ConVal.
The trough.
Say again?
The trough.
The trough is correct for the 10 points. Complete the title of the following story by Edgar Allan Poe. Fall of the House of... It is the fall of the House of Usher. 50 years after Mount Everest was conquered, one of Nepal's expert mountain guides set up the world's highest internet cafe at the base camp, 17,400 feet up the peak. What word beginning with S names him as one of these expert Nepalese guides? The word we're looking for is a Sherpa. Which German composer took Schiller's Ode to Joy and set it to music in the finale of his ninth or choral symphony, Emily of ConVal?
Beethoven.
Beethoven is correct. Tell me now for 10 points, which cabinet department was created to foster, promote, and develop the welfare of the wage earners of the United States? James of Monadnock.
Department of Labor.
The Department of Labor is correct. One test for the iron ion is to add a solution containing thiocyanate ions. What color is produced when FeSCN2 positive forms? Tom of Monadnock.
Red.
Red is correct. Paper and pencil is in front of you should you need it for this question. X cubed times X squared is how much greater than the quantity X cubed plus X squared if X equals 2? We'll give you some time now. X equals 2. If X cubed times X squared is how much greater than the quantity X cubed plus X squared, Tom of Monadnock?
20.
20 is correct. What word ending in C-I-D-E means killing of another person? David of ConVal.
Homicide.
Homicide is right. On October 3rd, 1951, which player for which team hit the home run off Brooklyn Dodgers' Ralph Branca, known as the shot heard round the world since it won the 1951 National League pennant? Emily of ConVal.
Mickey Mantle.
Monadnock Regional. It's a tough one, but it was a shot heard around the world back then. Bobby Thompson hitting it for the New York Giants. In 1963, Niagara was the nation's second largest hydroelectric generating plant, trailing only what other dam on the Columbia River, David of ConVal?
The Hoover Dam.
Monadnock. It is the Grand Coulee Dam. What is the general name for a type of soil composed of particles less than 0.01 millimeters in diameter and through which, Tom of Monadnock?
Topsoil.
Can repeat it for ConVal. What is the general name for a type of soil composed of particles less than 0.01 millimeters in diameter and through which water passes very slowly? Josiah.
Silt.
It is clay. What word beginning with the letter T and derived from the Polynesian language of the South Sea Island of Tonga designates something that a culture considers an improper or even sacrilegious action, James of Monadnock?
Taboo.
Taboo is right. Identify the word for pulverized dried leaves of a non-poisonous plant of the cashew family used in tanning and dyeing. James of Monadnock.
Aloe.
Good try, ConVal. David.
Chamomile.
It is sumac. Identify the American absurdist playwright who wrote The American Dream, The Sandbox, and The Zoo Story. His name was Edward Albee. All right, here's your next 10-pointer, still right in the middle of our round. He was the first officer in the history of the U.S. Army to attain the rank of full general. He was also Secretary of War, becoming the 18th president. Name him. James of Monadnock.
Ulysses S. Grant.
Ulysses Grant is right. The four fundamental forces of nature are electromagnetism, the strong and weak nuclear forces, and what? James of Monadnock.
Gravity.
Judges, will you take that? Gravitational force is correct. Paper and pencil in front of you, teams. If set A consists of all the two-digit multiples of 8 that are less than 50, how many elements would there be in set A? If set A consists of all the two-digit, Emily of ConVal?
5.
5 is right. Just under a minute to go in our round. Give the proper nouns in the following sentence. Charles Dickens wrote a story of the French Revolution. Sarah of Monadnock.
Charles Dickens, French Revolution.
You got them all, that's correct. For 10 more points, teams, in another ceremony marking the 50th anniversary of VE Day, world leaders signed and placed on a map of the world leaves from which kind of branch long regarded as a symbol of peace, Tom of Monadnock?
Olive.
An olive branch is right. For 10 points, well, you're going to have to wait on that. There's the sound ending our round. Monadnock getting a little bit of a lead here after round number one by a score of 90 to 40, a good high-scoring round to get our game underway this evening. But before we get into our bonus round, we're going to take our first time out this evening and ask Tim Astilos to join us. He talked with the members of the team from ConVal prior to the program. Let's find out what they had to say.
I'm here with the team from ConVal High School, a team that's not only very smart, but also very creative as well. David is the team captain. You write poetry, right?
Yeah, I do write poetry. I've been writing since I was in eighth grade, and I really enjoy it.
And you're also a filmmaker. Tell me about some of the details on that.
Yeah, you know, I try to make films. I've only made one film so far. It's called Choking Harry, and it's a comedy about a guy who's choking on a sandwich.
Oh, yeah, that's always a fun subject. You know, and what made you come up with that one?
Well, I actually didn't come up with it. My friends, you know, they said, hey, Dave, we need someone to fill in something. So they had me do it.
And his next epic will be about a guy coughing up a lung. Think about that one, okay? Now, Alice over here, you're into knitting. What kind of things do you knit?
Well, I've been knitting since I was 8, and I am working on my first sweater, but I knit a lot of hats and scarves, and I knitted a poncho for an art project a couple years ago.
Which always comes in handy around Christmas time for presents and that kind of thing. Yeah. Now, you also are working with the drama group at school. Tell me about that.
Yes, I'm really into acting. I've done 3 summers at Andy's Summer Playhouse, which is a lot of fun, and I just tried out for the school fall play.
Okay, and if you don't pick her for the play, I'm going to come to your house, and you don't want that to happen. Now, Emily down here, she is into choreographing dance.
Yeah, I attend this dance camp, and this summer it was a choreography camp trained to get us older folks back, and I choreographed 2 dances this year. Well, one was all my own, and that was really fun. NHDI style, it's more upbeat, energetic, and the other one was with my friends.
So is this something you'd like to pursue as a career in the future?
It's really something I do to relax whenever the spirit moves me.
Okay. Well, sounds very good. Now, Josiah over here, he is building something called a theremin. What's that?
A theremin's an electronic instrument that you don't touch. It's the only instrument that you play without touching it.
It's kind of electronic. Now, also, he's not into hockey, but he knows how to do a hat trick. So show us this hat trick. You got it? Pull back. I tell you, you know, what a talented group. Now, you also play bass guitar as well.
Yes, I do. I play the bass guitar, the upright bass, and the tuba and sousaphone in other bands.
So, you know, you're very musically inclined, I understand.
Yeah.
Okay. In an answer, just that it is. I'm going to take his hat. We're going to get back to the game. This is your team from ConVal High School. Very good.
And there they are, the members of Contucoc Valley Regional High School, right now after the first round, trailing by a score of 90-40, hoping to come right back here in the second round, a round in which we offer bonus points. We'll give the 10-point toss-up questions, get it right, have a chance at additional bonus points. So good luck to your 2 teams, Monadnock and ConVal. Here we go. What 2 Massachusetts towns both claim to be the site of the first battle of the American Revolution? Sarah of Monadnock?
Lexington and Concord.
Lexington and Concord is correct. So we'll go over to Monadnock. James, you're the team captain. You can talk to everybody about a category, and then when we ask, we'll tell you that we take your answer for the team. Let's choose a category. Got a date? It wasn't built in a day. Nice work if you can get it. Got a date? It wasn't built in a day. Nice work if you can get it.
Nice work.
We'll take nice work if you can
nice
get it.
Nice work if you can get it. Again, you can talk to everybody, but I take your answer, James. For the team, identify the primary occupation which made the following individuals famous. A.E. Housman, 1859 to 1936. Try a guess, James.
Architect.
He was a writer or a poet. Charles Auguste de Coulombe, 1736 to 1806. And he was a physicist. Engelbert Humperdinck, 1845 to 1921.
What did he do, right? Writer.
Say again?
Author.
He was a composer. All right, a tough category. Let's try another one on for size. For 10 points, teams, which hospital in Atlanta is named for the Georgia doctor who first used ether as an anesthetic in surgery? His name was Crawford Long, Crawford Long Hospital. At a 1995 Madison Square Garden tribute to Yitzhak Rabin, Kathleen Turner read "O Captain, My Captain," Walt Whitman's poem, about the death of which U.S. president? Alice of ConVal.
Abraham Lincoln.
Abraham Lincoln is correct for your 10 points. So let's go over to ConVal. David, you're the team captain. Choose from "Got a Date," "It Wasn't Built in a Day," or "I Left My Heart In." Got a date? It wasn't built in a day. I left my heart in.
It wasn't built in a day, please.
It wasn't built in a day. All right, David, I take your answer for the team after you talk to everybody. Answer the following questions about the Roman Empire. Why do historians know the legend that Nero played the fiddle while Rome burned to be false? Go ahead.
Nero didn't play the fiddle?
Nope, it's because ancient Rome predated the invention of the fiddle. All right, what Egyptian city was the second largest in the Roman Empire? And it was Alexandria. Under whose reign was Britain conquered in AD 43? And it was Claudius. All right, having trouble so far with our bonus questions, but let's try another 10-point toss-up. Which H.G. Wells novel did Orson Welles broadcast as a radio drama, Alice of ConVal?
War of the Worlds.
War of the Worlds will give ConVal another shot at these. Got a date? I left my heart in Satellite Plight. Got a date. I left my heart in Satellite
Plight. Can we have I left my heart in, please?
I left my heart in. Answer these questions about San Francisco. On the North Coast is what area known for docks, piers, and seafood restaurants? It's known as...
The Bay Area?
As Fisherman's Wharf. What area of old San Francisco shares its name with an area of North Africa infested by pirates? It's the Barbary Coast. And what was Joe Montana's home ballpark during his career with the 49ers?
Football. 49ers Stadium?
It was Candlestick Park. All right, here we go with another 10-point toss-up. No, we don't. We had some toss-ups. Didn't have a whole lot of success with the bonuses, but the round is ended, and we still have a good game going. This game's still up for grabs with Monadnock holding on to a 100-60 lead. All right, we're going to get into our 60-second round in a moment. First of all, though, Tim comes back to join us, talking with the team from Monadnock Regional.
I'm here with a group from Monadnock Regional High School, and if they look familiar to you, they should. They've been playing Granite State Challenge before, but they're going to do even better this time around. James is the team captain. Now, you are in scouting. What rank are you right now?
Right now, I'm a life, but I just finished my UL project this summer. I repaired a trail on Honey Hill, which is a local hiking trail by our town hall.
Now, you're also involved with something called Interact. What is that?
Interact's a community service organization. It's sponsored by the Rotary Club, and sponsor part of the highway. We send a trip down to El Salvador to build some homes for people, too, each year.
Very, very commendable. It's nice to see the youth getting involved with these things. Now, Sarah has visited an Indian reservation. Tell me about that. Where did you go?
I actually spent 2 weeks this summer in South Dakota. We visited a small community called Iron Lightning, and we worked with children at a YMCA there.
Now, what prompted you to get involved with that? Have you always had an interest in, you know, Native Americans, that kind of thing?
I just really enjoy volunteering for things, and I also thought it would be really interesting to see what another culture lives like.
Is this something you'd like to go back and maybe do again?
Yeah, I would definitely like to.
Okay, now down here in front we have Tom. Now, Tom is into a bunch of things. You're involved with math. You enjoy that quite a bit, right?
Yeah, I actually, in junior high, participated in the Math Counts organization. We did really well in that recently. Just been going through our classes. I enjoy doing it. It comes easy to me, so it works out.
And he also was at Harvard this year taking a summer class there. Now, Steve here in front, he's into computers. What aspects of that do you enjoy?
I like a lot of web design and Flash. And Flash is a program that you can make web design and other stuff like that with.
So if anybody needs a website, he's the guy to see. You also play tennis, right?
Yep. I played it in spring. This would be my fourth year this year. And I enjoy that a lot. It's really good.
Yes, sir. He is aiming for going to Wimbledon someday, but right now he's got a win right here at Grand State Challenge. This is your team from Monadnock Regional High School.
And you look at the Huskies from Monadnock Regional High School, and halfway through our game, they hold on to a 40-point lead, 100-60. As we come into our third round, which is our 60-second round, we'll be asking each team 10 questions in 1 minute. We give them 10 points for every correct answer and bonus them 10 should they get them all right in under a minute. So each team has an opportunity for as many as 110 points. The team that trails chooses the categories first. So we go over to ConVal and you can choose from the letter W, fill in the blank, which is which? The letter W, fill in the blank, which is which?
We'll take fill in the blank, please.
Fill in the blank. All right. David, you can talk to everybody, but I take your answer for the team. Complete each of the following sayings. Start the clock. A chip off the old.
Block.
Correct. To have a chip on one's
shoulder.
Correct. Let the chips blank where they may.
Fall.
Correct. To take the blank by the horns.
Bull.
Correct. To flog a dead
horse.
Correct. To kill the blank that lays the golden eggs.
Goose.
Correct. Hope springs eternal in the human
Heart.
Breast. Don't look a gift horse in the...
Mouth.
Correct. To wear one's blank on one sleeve.
Heart.
Correct. Absent makes the heart grow.
Fonder.
Simple enough for 9 out of 10, I believe, and that's 90 big points going on the scoreboard for ConVal in their 60-second round. So let's see if Monadnock Regional can write back at them for choosing between the letter W or which is which.
We'll take the letter W.
Let's go with the letter W. And James, as you know, you're the captain, and I take your answer for the team. Identify each of the following by giving an answer including the letter W. Start the clock. Poem by Lewis Carroll that includes the lines, "'Twas brillig and the slithy toves did gyre and gimble in the wabe."
Pass.
E.B. Whitework, whose first line is, "'Where's Papa going with that axe?"
Charlotte's Web.
Correct. What Hans Christian Andersen's ugly duckling develops into the end of the story?
Swan.
Correct. Pen name of Samuel Langhorne Clemens.
Mark Twain.
Correct. Physicist who formulated the second law of motion.
Isaac Newton.
Correct. U.S. president during whose term the cotton gin was patented by Eli Whitney. Want to pass?
Wilson.
It was Washington. State whose capital is Dover.
Delaware.
Correct. Shoshone Indian wife who served as guide for the Lewis and Clark Expedition. Correct. Famous financial district. That's the sound ending the round. They got 6 out of 10 on their 60-second round. So as we put their points onto the board, we see that as we head into the home stretch, we have a good one going here as Monadnock holds on to a 160 to 150 lead. All right. 10-point toss-ups the rest of the way, teams. No more talking to each other now. Good luck, and here we go. In which war was Matthew Brady, a famous photographer? Alice of ConVal.
Civil War.
The Civil War is correct. What country is the site of the Three Gorges Dam? David of ConVal. Say again.
China.
China is correct. Which planet, the fifth largest planet known, well, I'm going to start again. Which planet, the fifth largest known one in our solar system, has surface temperatures that vary about 265 degrees Fahrenheit and air that is about 78% nitrogen? David?
Mars.
Monadnock, James?
Venus.
It is Earth. 7/8 of what number is 105? Paper and pencil if you need it, and we'll give you a little time on that. We want to know 7/8 of what number is 105? The number was 120. Name this 5-syllable word from the Greek for great city. It's a huge conglomeration of cities. David of ConVal.
Acropolis.
James of Monadnock.
Megalopolis.
Megalopolis is correct. What word completes the term blank period, designated the time a person has to pay for credit card purchases in full without being charged interest, usually 20 to 25 days? Blank period. David of ConVal.
Pay period.
Monadnock. Tom.
Free period.
It is a grace period. Colorful lava walls tower above what deep blue lake in Oregon? Tom of Monadnock.
Boulder Lake.
ConVal. It is Crater Lake. In August, unusually strong winds along Florida's Atlantic coast produced cold ocean waters that left 1,000 baby turtles suffering from overexposure to cold temperatures. Medically, this is known by what name beginning, James of Monadnock?
Hypothermia.
Hypothermia is correct. The 16 wordsmiths who worked 13 years on the new shorter Oxford English Dictionary are known by which word beginning with the letter L? James of Monadnock.
Linguist.
ConVal. lexicographers. We have 1 minute to play in our game. Which young man in Greek myth fell in love with his own image in a pond? Sarah of Monadnock.
Narcissus.
Narcissus is correct. Identify the percussion instrument that consists of a pair of thin metal plates that can be clashed together. Sarah of Monadnock.
Cymbals.
Cymbals is right. Identify the three types of fossil fuels formed from the remains of plants and animals that lived millions of years ago. James of Monadnock.
Coal, oil, and gasoline, natural gas.
Yes, they'll take that. Coal, petroleum, and natural gas. Skip the next one. What word beginning with the letter P refers to any water which falls from the air, such as rain? Alice of ConVal.
Precipitation.
Precipitation is right. Baltimore's Iron Man player voluntarily ended his streak in 1998 of playing 2,632. Emily of ConVal.
Cal Ripken Jr.
That is not, yes, it is, Cal Ripken Jr., and there's the sound ending our game. And what a game we had here tonight. Nip and tuck, and Monadnock holds on down to the wire, pulling off a 210 to 190 victory over ConVal. Congratulations to both teams so far in our early season. That's the closest competition we have had, and a very exciting game it was as well. Hope you enjoyed it at home, and as a result, will join us again for week number 5 of our 25th anniversary year come next week, when the teams from Goffstown High School and Winneconnon Regional High School come to do battle against each other. Thanks for watching tonight. Good night, everybody. See you in a week. Good night.